new experimental findings cast doubt on a 90-year-old theoretical model of the transition state in chemical reactions. Let's dive in and find out more. Researchers were studying the collision of molecules by launching a fluorine atom at the center of a fluoromethyl molecule. This is made up of one carbon atom and three fluorine atoms. They observed the reaction using a scanning tunnel microscope. The idea of throwing molecules at each other in the hopes of making something new is something that chemists often do. It has been well known for over a century that there is an energy barrier that chemical reagents must cross on their way to forming reaction products. Briefly, before they reach this state, at the top of this barrier, there is an energized transition state. If the reagents are not able to reach this transition state, they are not able to react. In the 1930s, chemists started to calculate the likelihood of forming a transition state on the assumption that it would cause the energy to become scrambled like a hot molecule. This gave rise to the statistical transition state theory of reaction rates. This means that when firing a fluorine atom at the fluoromethyl molecule, the resultant intermediary state would last for long enough to cause the randomization of the motion, and the resultant ejected fluorine atom would be ejected in a random direction. What the researchers discovered, however, was that the reactant product emerged in a straight line, moving in the same direction as the incoming reagent atom, suggesting that the motion that caused the reaction are also responsible for the onward transfer of momentum. The conservation of linear momentum observed suggests a short-lived transition state, rather than the previous view that there is sufficient time for randomization of motion. This creates the rather pleasing idea that nature permits a simple knock-on event to describe something as complex as a chemical reaction. In order to achieve this reaction, the scientists had to create a means of controlling whether the molecule that was being launched towards another would either collide head-on with its target or miss by a chosen amount. This is called the impact parameter. The higher the value, the more it misses by. For this reaction, they had to design a way to ensure that this was zero to give head-on collisions only. They dubbed this one-dimensional chemical reaction knock-on, as the product is knocked on in the same direction as the incoming one. They were able to place fluoromethyl molecules on a substrate of copper. This caused them to become perfectly aligned in rows. In order to fire the fluorine atom at the target, they used a process of electron-induced dissociation of one of the fluoromethyl chains. This caused the fluorine atom to recoil along the copper row and collide with the second fluoromethyl chain. The reaction resembles Newton's cradle, where the steel balls pass on the momentum to one another. They do not physically pass through each other, but efficiently transfer momentum along a line. Similarly, these knock-on reactions transfer energy along rows of molecules, thereby favoring a chain reaction. The results from this experiment clearly show that the fluorine atom is effectively knocked on from one molecule to the next in the same straight line. This means the transition state lasts for such a small period of time that it is not capable of scrambling its momenta. They estimate that it could be as short as a million millionth of a second. Even when the knock-on was not successful, there is an obvious pattern produced which is not random at all. So here we have yet another example of experiments showing that our understanding of the universe can be fundamentally flawed through decisions made decades ago. It also reveals that simple things like how atoms interact in chemical reactions can still throw up many questions about what exactly atoms are and how they interact with each other. Here we have atoms fired at molecules that appear to behave just like marbles, with very little randomness at play. As always, be brave, be curious. The truth is waiting for us. Until next time.